So I've got, and I'll just quickly talk about this research. So I'm sure that we can all agree that in this age of technology and the internet and all of its content so widely available, we need to have a way to protect children in their online and prevent them from accessing sites with unsuitable content. But what mechanism do we currently use to do that? I'm sure we all know these. Except that they aren't really security mechanisms, and they are not out there to protect the children, they're there to protect companies from legal implications. Well, but there are other methods, for example these. So many sites will ask their users to provide credit card details to prove that they are adults, and it's based on the assumption that only adults have access to credit cards, which I'm not really convinced is always true. I mean, after all, how hard would it be to for a teenager to copy mom and dad's credit card details. Another way are those internet ID cards or digital passports. So the idea is that you apply for one and you can use them to prove that you're an adult if you want to access an adult. But they're not that great either because they're not very convenient. They might take a long time to obtain and they do require a lot of personal information to be disclosed. They're not very widely adopted or supported. Besides, do we really want to go through all that hassle of applying for these and disclosing our personal information and credit card details just to be able to access one site? I guess not. So there's a technique that's been proposed in the computing science department at this university that would distinguish whether a website user is an adult or a child by testing the user's knowledge of the past. So what we do, we would do something like this. So clearly adults been around for longer, so they'll know more than they'll know more about the past than children would know. I mean, of course, children might know, like many of them might know who Sean Connery is and how he looks. But they will not match the knowledge of the adults. So in theory, if we ask enough questions, then we should be able to make a distinction. But to be able to properly assess the effectiveness of this method, we first need to carry out an experiment to be able to derive a set of images that would last to so reliably. And the images, the experiment would involve looking at a blind set of images of famous people, TV shows, cars, suites, and just simply answering who or what's on that picture. Yeah, well, that's inaccurate because you're obviously not looking for donations. so that's a lie, but we still would like to use some of your help. So we want to carry out this experiment with as many S1 and S2 pupils as possible. That would be really appreciated if we could do that in your schools. If you're interested, I would be more than happy to pass you a link to the web app that will be used in the experiment so you can have a look at it beforehand. And very soon we'll be applying for the ethics approval as well, so there shouldn't be any problems with that. If you'll be kind enough to at least consider participation, or if you have any questions that you would want me to answer later on, I left some forms here so you can put your name down or after the wine reception that I'll come around as well. And I also put some cards with my email address if you would like to contact me. So thank you so much. Thank you very much for your attention.